everyone. My name is Helen and I've got one request for a bookshelf tour, and that's enough for me. So I'm gonna do a bookshelf tour today. Before I do the tour, I have two comments for you, so listen carefully. The first comment is that my books are not ordered in genre. You will see a mix of both young adult and biographies and chick lit all mingled together. That means that you cannot just skip forward in my video and just skip to the young adult section, because I don't have such a section. Yeah, you will have to live with that. My number two comment is that I have quite a lot of books in French and in Danish. What I'm going to do is that I'm going to translate the titles that are in Danish, but I'm not going to translate the titles that are in French. Well, I could have done that, but I feel like that will take too much time, and also you should have some work to do yourself. Let's get started. Here you can see my bookshelves in their entirety, and there is still room for expansion. I have lots of room for new books, but in these bookshelves I have about 200 books, so that still counts for something, and I'm happy that I have room for more. So this is my very first shelf, and it contains Kiss and Tell by Alain de Botton, Timbuktu by Paul Auster, L'élégance du hérisson by Muriel Barbery, The Hours by Michael Cunningham, and by Cecilia Ahern I have Diary from Tomorrow, If You Could See Me Now, Someplace Nearby, and Thanks for the Memories. Lucy Sullivan is Getting Married by Marianne Case, Death Comes to Pemberley by P.D. James, A Half Forgotten Song by Catherine Webb, Happy Birthday by Daniel Steele, Last Night in Twisted River by John Irving, La Condition Humaine by André Malraux, and by Neil Gaiman I have The Sandman, Book of Dreams, Stardust, and Neverwhere, Sophie's World by Justine Gardner, War and Peace by Leo Tolstoy, and yes, I've read this, Vandalism by Tom Christensen, a very famous Danish book, and this was a gift from my mother. It is a little book called Always My Daughter. Revenge Wears Prada by Lauren Weisberger, and this is the sequel to The Devil Wears Prada. Between a Mother and Her Child by Elizabeth Noble. Le Premier Homme by Albert Camus. The Prince of Tides by Pat Conroy. And by Simone de Beauvoir I have Le Deuxième Sexe number 1 and Le Deuxième Sexe number 2. On my second shelf I have first a book by Khaled Hosseini called And the Mountains Echoed, and I thought it looked so pretty that I had to put it on display like this. Then we have Fatima's Hand by Ildefonso Falcones, 100-Year-Old Who Crawled Out the Window and Disappeared by Jonas Jonasson, Official Book Club Selection by Kathy Griffin, and by Cynthia Hand I have Unearthly number 1 and Unearthly number 2. Here we have Hajin with Under the Red Flag, and this is a compilation of analysis of Bret Easton Ellis's American Psycho, Glamorama, and Luna Park, The Fundamentalist by Jan Guillou, and the very provocative title I Kill by Giorgio Faletti. On this shelf I have a little Buddha, and I think he looks nice and peaceful, and he is taking care of my books, at least I like to think so, and I also have some cards beside him. And the books. This is a book about being polite in other countries, how to be polite in other countries, and it was written by a university professor of mine, so that's pretty cool, I think. Then we have Luna Park by Bret Easton Ellis, Lady Oracle by Margaret Atwood, by Neil Gaiman I have Anansi Boys, and Coraline, Sosa Boy by Ken Saro Viva, The Hearing Trumpet by Leonora Carrington, and A Ciel Ouvert by Nelia Khan. Here we have the beginning of my next shelf, and it is mostly paperbacks. Devil Wears Prada by Lauren Weisberger, Living, Thinking, Looking by Siri Hustvedt, and I have a whole lot of books by the Japanese writer Haruki Murakami. I have Norwegian Wood, A Crazy Sheep Hunt, Dance Dance Dance, Sputnik My Love, South of the Border, West to the Sun, and The Wind Up Bird Chronicle, The Bell Jar by Sylvia Plath, The Catcher in the Rye by J.D. Salinger, Old Possum's Book of Practical Cats by T.S. Eliot, November 22nd, 1963 by Stephen King, Rot and Ruin by Jonathan Maybury, The Host by Stephanie Meyer, Angel Fall by Susan E. Persuasion by Jane Austen. No! The Virgin Suicides by Geoffrey Eugene. The Fault in Our Stars by John Green. The last part of this shelf contains Uglies, Pretties, Specials, and Extras by Scott Westerfeld. The Corrections by Jonathan Franzen. I Am Charlotte Simmons by Tom Wolfe. And then I have the three books in the trilogy by Haruki Murakami called 1Q84. Down here I start with the Danish book, Duckhead by Morten Ramsland. Then we have two books by Kelly Cutrone, No More Gets You Nowhere, If You Have to Cry, Go Outside. Then I have the French version by Lauren Weisberger of The Devil Wears Prada, and in French it is Le Diable s'habille en Prada. The Brothers Karamazov by Fyodor Dostoevsky. Nickel and Dimed by Barbara Ehrenreich. Watching the English by Kate Fox. This is the bottom shelf of my first bookcase, and here we have Completed Works by William Shakespeare. La Cause des Femmes by Giselle Halimi. The Cinderella Complex by Colette Dowling. This one is called Sisterhood, and the funny thing is I haven't been able to find an author was for this book. Obviously someone has written this book, but I can't figure out who, so you will have to live without that information. Dustball by Faye Wilden. The Dump Waiter by Hal Pinter. Last Tales by Isaac Dinesen, a.k.a. Karen Blixen. By Tori Spelling I have Uncharted Territory and Mummywood. Last I have L'Aube Soir ou la Nuit by Jasmine Reza. So, if you haven't fallen asleep yet, I will move on to bookshelf number 2. Up here we have The Stolen Road by Anne-Catherine Rybnitsky. The Courage to Hope by Barack Obama. The Search for Harry Winston by Lauren Weisberger. And by Marianne Keyes I have Sushi for Beginners, Rachel's Vacation, and Watermelon. By Rosamund Pilcher I have The Shell Seekers and Coming Home. The Seventh Child by Eric Valeur and The Art of Fielding by Chet Harbach. Over here I have my book jar. It is basically a jar I created with book titles that I haven't read yet. So when I feel like it, I just pick one and I read the book that I have picked. Here we have one of my favorite bookshelves just because it contains some of my favorite books. And these are The Casual Vacancy by J.K. Rowling, Fall of the Giants and Winter's World by Ken Follett, The Hunger Games Trilogy by Suzanne Collins, Hunger Games, Catching Fire, and Mockingjay, Daughter of Fire and Bone by Lainey Taylor, The Program by Suzanne Young, by Lauren Oliver I have Delirium, Pandemonium, and Before I Fall. Here we have The Book Thief by Marcus Zusak, Shatter Me by Tahereh Mafi, and by Marisa Mayer I have Cinder and Scarlet, Reboot by Amy Tintera, Back to Cold Mountain by Charles Frazier, and by Veronica Roth I have Divergent and also Insurgent. The biography about Steve Jobs, and it is written by Walter Isaacson. The Cuckoo's Calling by Robert Galbraith, and that is, of course, J.K. Rowling. In One Person by John Irving. The Clown Shalimar by Salman Rushdie. Inferno by Dan Brown. Legend and Prodigy by Marie Lu. You Disappear by Christian Youngerson. Then I have The Beautiful Creatures series, and that is Beautiful Creatures, Beautiful Darkness, Beautiful Chaos, and Beautiful Redemption by Garcia and Stoll. I'm not going to take these out because they are difficult to get back in the box. Moving on to my Cassandra Clare section, and that is first the Mortal Instruments series, City of Bones, City of Ashes, City of Glass, City of Fallen Angels, and City of Lost Souls. By Cassandra Clare I also have the Infernal Devices series, Clockwork Prince, Clockwork Angel, and Clockwork Princess. On this shelf I only have two books, and that is Just for the Record by Jerry Halliwell and Me Before You by Jojo Moyes. Next we have this bookshelf, which contains The Quarters of the Orange by Joanne Harris, Don Quixote by Cervantes, and yes, I've read this one, Anna Karenina by Leo Tolstoy, Happily Ever After by Harriet Evans, The Strangest Child by Alan Hollinghurst, The Graveyard Book by Neil Gaiman, Summer Without Men by Siri Hustvedt, One Good Turn by Kate Atkinson, and then I have the trilogy by Stieg Larsson, The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo, and actually the Danish title is Men Who Hate Women, so that's quite a different translation. The Girl Who Played with Fire. And the last part of the trilogy is The Girl Who Kicked the Hornet's Nest. Here is American Gods by Neil Gaiman and The Earth Beneath Her Feet by Salman Rushdie. Down here I have first a furry cat on the left, and he just looks so comfortable there. Then I have American Psycho by Bret Easton Ellis, Thérèse Raquin by Émile Zola, and by Neil Gaiman I have Fragile Things and Good Omens, and this one is also by Terry Pratchett. The Other Side of the Story by Marion Case, Les Jappés Belles by Anna Gavalda, Ensemble C'est Tout by Anna Gavalda, and Je l'aimais by Anna Gavalda. Madame Bovary by Gustave Flaubert. By Milan Kundera I have L'insoutenable légèreté de lettres, Le livre du rire et de l'oubli, Risible Amour, and La Lenteur. Then I have Sacré Français by Ted Stanger, Picture of Dorian Gray by Oscar Wilde, Robinson Crusoe by Daniel Defoe, Le Germinal by Émile Zola, Memoirs of a Geisha by Arthur Golden, Jacques Rantécole by Daniel Pennac, by Nelly Acan I have Folle and Putain. And last I have another biography by Jerry Halliwell called If Only. These were my two bookshelves, and now I move on to bookshelf number 3, the last bookshelf. Up here we have first a nice little mug with cats. It was a gift from my previous French teacher, and it just has some nice cats on it. Over here we have the 50 Shades of Grey trilogy by E.L. James, 50 Shades of Grey, Darker, and Freed. Moving on to my next bookshelf, which contains first Pivot Point by K.C. West, and that is the book on the left. I thought that it looked very pretty, so that's why I've displayed it like this. The next books are The Unlikely Pilgrimage of Hell Fry by Rachel Joyce, Still Alice by Lisa Genova, and then I have these six books, which are all part of a series called My Battle. They were written by Karl Ove Knausgård, who is from Sweden, and the books are actually based on Hitler's Mein Kampf. I have only read the five of them. I still need to read the number six, but I really, really love these books. They are amazing. They are biographies, and Carlo Knausgård just writes amazingly. This shelf only has four books and then some sweet little cats. First we have Being Kendra by Kendra Wilkinson, Angels and Demons by Dan Brown, and actually I also have the Da Vinci Code somewhere, but I don't have it with me now. Canada by Richard Ford, and Nobody's Fool by Richard Rousseau. And I also have Empire Falls by Richard Rousseau, but my mother has bought that one. Here we have my Harry Potter shelf, and it contains some beautiful glasses, as you can see. And then we have the seven Harry Potter books by J.K. Rowling. Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone, Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets, Harry Potter and the Prisoner of Azkaban, Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire, Harry Potter and the Order of Phoenix, Harry Potter and the Half-Blood Prince, and last but not least, Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows. On this shelf I have some more paperbacks. I have David Copperfield and Great Expectations by Charles Dickens. Please. Survivor by Sharon Osbourne, Sweet Little Lies by Lauren Conrad, Piece by Piece by Terry Amos and Anne Powers, La Consolante by Anna Gavalda, and then I have the Twilight series, Twilight, New Moon, Eclipse, and Breaking Dawn, all by Stephanie Meyer. And now I have reached my very last shelf, and that is just a compilation of photo albums and cooking books. So I'm not going to show you these. That's it for today. I hope you enjoyed my books and my video. If you have any questions, you can just leave a comment and I will be happy to answer. So I'm going to leave you now, but happy reading everyone, and bye bye!